Hey everyone, this is Sandra here. Welcome to my kitchen. I haven't updated a cooking vlog in a while, except for some photo ones. I apologize. However, today I'm just gonna make some simple spaghetti sauce. And I kinda like to call it whatever I have in the kitchen spaghetti sauce. So that's what we're gonna do today. Hey, and if you haven't checked out bakespace.com, now is the time. They redid their website. It's totally awesome, and I'm one of the mentors. So, come on over to bakespace.com, www.bakespace.com. Tell Babs that Sandra sent you, and I'll see you there. But in the meantime, I'm going to prepare for simple spaghetti sauce. The whole purpose of this recipe is sometimes you just don't have enough time to make a really, 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 really elaborate meal. But you still can make a delicious meal in just a little bit of time, in about 30 minutes or less. Just look in your cupboard and see what you have. Tonight, I'm making spaghetti sauce. I have the tomatoes, which I'm using one big can and two small cans. And since I don't have a lot of fruit and veg in my house right now because I haven't been shopping in a while, I'm using the roasted garlic and the green pepper and celery and onion tomatoes to add to my sauce because I only had two small onions and I did have some fresh garlic, so we can spice it up that way. Oh, and I had tons of mushrooms, so I decided to throw some mushrooms in there. Don't forget your Italian seasoning if you have it. Other than that, just add some oregano or whatever in it. And of course, a pound of ground beef, or use veggie crumbles, whatever your choice is. So now we're gonna start preparing the meal. First thing that we're gonna do is in our skillet is brown some ground beef and of course the onions. I'm just gonna add the beef here and it's already nice and hot. I'm gonna chop that up. And you guys need to remember, cooking is not rocket science. You can make up pretty much anything if you have the basics in your house. And that's exactly what this spaghetti sauce is. Next, I'm throwing the onions. Now, I have these onions a little chunky because I want this as a chunky sauce. I'm going to break them up just a wee bit. Now, of course, you can always cut up your onions much finer. But I want this to be a really hearty, hearty sauce, so. Now, I'm going to let that brown for about 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Just until the hamburger meat is nice and golden brown. Okay, this has been browning for a little while, and it's still not quite done. But just remember, if you're not using a really lean beef, you want to go ahead and drain your meat after you get done browning it. I actually use a pretty lean meat, but I'm noticing there's just a little bit too much fat in here that I don't want. So about this stage, where it's just not quite done, the meat, I'm going to go ahead and drain it. And then let it brown just a little bit more before I add the... Okay, I have drained my meat. I'm putting it back in a skillet here. And by the way, I have this on an electric stove about number 6. It's about medium heat. Next I'm going to add is my garlic. I love my garlic crisp. This is cool garlic crisp. So, push that through. And push some more through. Oh, quick garlic tip. The best way to peel garlic if you're peeling like a lot of it, especially like for tzatziki or something, my Greek friend taught me this, is actually undo your clove, your big bulb of garlic And then put each individual clove in a bowl of water. Like cool water, not warm water or hot water, because you don't want to cook your garlic. And then wait about 10 minutes, and your garlic skin just like peels straight off. I used to help her out in a restaurant all the time, and that's how I peeled the garlic for the tzatziki. And it was the most awesome trick I ever learned about garlic. Okay, I need to turn my fan on here. So it might get a little noisy. And I turned down my heat to about a 4 or 3. And I'm going to add my tomatoes and my mushrooms. Okay, I'm adding my tomatoes. Now if you want, you can add about half a can of water, which I think I'm going to do. And what I kind of do is I swish it back and forth between cans to get all the juicy bits out of there. And I have one more can. Now these are whole tomatoes, so they're really, really chunky. Normally what I do is just stick my hand in there and kind of like chop them up before I even put them in the skillet. But I omitted that step, so I'm going to chop it up a little bit with my wooden spoon here. But don't be afraid to stick your hand in there and just kind of like chop up the tomatoes, but be careful of the sharp edges. I'm adding a little bit more water. And we're going to add our mushrooms. I'm adding 2 little small cans of mushrooms. These are 4 ounces, so a total of 8 ounces. And I drain the juice out of the mushrooms. And I had totally forgotten that I actually have some bell pepper that's in the freezer. And normally I would add that when I'm frying the meat. But, you know, hindsight. This is off the cuff, remember? It's just made up recipe. Okay, and then we're going to want to stir that all the way around. Literally, this is how easy this recipe is. You can do this recipe in 30 minutes, 20 minutes. I'm not cooking the pasta right now because the way I have my camera set up, it's partly set up on my stove. But the best thing to do is when you're cooking the sauce is start boiling your water for your pasta. If you want spaghetti or just normal pasta, just make sure it's normally about 7 to 10 minutes. And you just want it where that has that nice bite to it and it's al dente. Next, I'm going to add some seasoning. Now this lovely seasoning is a combination of some spices I bought in Italy. It's kind of hot, but I had added some milder stuff to it. So I'm just going to use about that much. I think that's pretty good. A little bit more. So about a tablespoon. Being a little generous with it. And I'm just going to mix it up. And then I'm going to let it simmer probably another 10 minutes, 15 minutes. And you have your simple spaghetti sauce. See how easy that was? The sauce is simmering right now, and I'll be making the pasta here shortly. I hope you enjoyed the video, and don't forget to check out Bakespace, www.bakespace.com, and tell Babs that Sandra sent you. Until next time!